Hey, hello everyone, this is Sharath here, welcoming you all to my YouTube channel. I hope you all are doing great today. So friends, once again I'm back with a very interesting video on the service training that was offered to all the Bajaj Domina owners of Bangalore by Khivraj Bajaj Motors. In this video, you will get to know how to clean and lube your chain, how to set your chain play, how to set your clutch play, and the most important part, how to jumpstart your bike when your self start fails. So there are a lot of other contents in the video, so make sure you're gonna watch the video till the end. And if you're liking this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and stay subscribed to my YouTube channel for more such interesting videos. So let's not waste more time and get straight into the video.
If you want, you can make it hide the ramp and you can stand up.
Yeah. Okay, everyone can see?
Yeah.
Oh, and whenever you guys remove it, always keep this bolt together because a lot of people remove and
forget. Don't interchange the positions.
And
do because not this is directly connected to your engine case. These bolts are. So length, if varies, no, it will lead to your oil seepage things. That's why.
Always just keep it separately and you know in order so that you remember.
Just mix with the diesel and engine oil.
1:1 ratio of diesel and engine oil. If you are not getting engine oil, you can go for gear oil also.
And that is compulsory?
Yeah, gear oil? That is compulsory.
Okay. Oil should be mixed. Diesel also harm the engine.
Okay.
That's why we mix the engine oil.
Why oil is, will not oil the, lubricate this chain with the oil. No? So if, while cleaning, if you are mixing with the diesel, that will lubricate the inner parts of that O-ring and all.
O-ring.
That's why we mix the oil.
Chain cleaner
you can use, but effective way of cleaning is with the diesel and oil.
What's the ratio?
We used with the cleaners and all, but the dust particles, chain cleaners mostly removes the rusted things, not the muddy things. But diesel, no, it dissolves the muddy things also.
What about kerosene?
You can.
What about cement?
Huh?
Motor cement.
Motor, I don't recommend.
Experience only you will get to know.
Right, and when you're cleaning this, it's preferred don't start the bike in first gear or second gear. Keep it.
That's a because safety thing. Many people got their fingers cut due to that. Many technicians, not even the customers, the expert thing people. And this way is just a tip to take away the mud from the sprocket cover, the metal cover. So easily you can take it away. Just put your floor, slowly you rotate the wheel. That will lock your chain with the cloth and remove all the dirt.
What is the ratio of that engine oil and...
1:1.
So what he does is, he takes the cloth and then, you know, just inserts over here on the top and slowly, you know, rotates it so that the dirt and everything gets wiped along. He does it like a couple of times, so until you see that.
See, these many dirts won't come with your cleaners.
And Senzel, how frequently do we need to do this?
500.
Every
500 is recommended. Because mud mostly accumulates here, not the back rear sprocket. In front sprocket, because it is closed, no? Easily mud can come and accumulate easily.
So after cleaning that, just all the dirt will be fallen on your, you know, gear lever and here and there. Just try wiping it off.
Why for gear lever is? So gear lever is also, again, it is engaged with your engine case. So the dirts may go inside your engine case. Even though the oil seals are there, oil seal is there, but even though, precaution, just a precaution.
Right, so that is done. Now you can all come this side. One's aches. Beach measure. Now this. You can all come here. Come back. All the short people can come forward.
Then Sambo is first.
That's why I said no, I'm already here. So what would be? Now what are you gonna do?
So in market you get many types of brushes, but this is not from Bajaj and all. But we see this brush is quite good
and effective
because it has brushes on the both sides, so it can simultaneously clean your upper side and lower side.
So it preferred you do it with hand rather than, you know, and just be little careful of your fingers. And this brush I think is around 150 rupees, somewhere 200 rupees. It's
and always rotate in the clockwise direction. So when you switch on the engine, it will be anti-clockwise direction, no? It will always throw away all the lubricants outside. In clockwise, lubrication will come inside the O-ring, but in anti-clockwise, it will throw away. That is why, one more thing why we should not switch on the engine and do the things.
But it's tough to do in zero.
See.
That's why I get to understand.
plug
and play. Hey, that he asked, so I suggested.
Yeah, actually, I too liked. I don't know what is the disadvantage or advantage of having this, but I like. Simply, that's I saw the center stand, I put it on the center stand. Otherwise, you people won't be having the paddocks. You will require your friend help to hold it in the side stand.
It's not touching in bumper at all.
Oh no, this is not touching. As of now, I've seen it.
Okay.
It is not touching.
And please clean your chain sprocket as well. So if you see, this brush has the other side also where it, you know, if you can't reach places, you can reach with that.
Many people clean the sprocket and chain, but they leave the shaft, wheel axle shaft. There also you have to clean because it is mounted on the bearings.
Where?
So, here, this is the part.
Okay.
So, if the dust are there in the bearings,
yeah,
it may cause your wheel bearing to fail. So, it will start wobbling the wheel. So, we have seen few cases where the people say wobbling, and when we open the wheel, no, bearing would have damaged because of dust inside it. Remove the excess diesel. You have to lube it, no? So after cleaning it, wipe it with the dry cloth because diesel is a solvent. So again your lubricant will be get dissolved in the diesel and it will fall off.
High speed, the sprocket color would be changing to the like, the metal color or the silver color. Is it because of the diesel wash or blade?
That is because they use blade. Few people use blade or metal wire brush. That is because of that. Because it removes little metal on it so that it looks classy thing. But it is not required as of such. Because chain sprocket, why you want to make chain sprocket look new? The whole idea is to clean the chain.
After washing with diesel chain, can we use the water gun and clean that?
Again, you have to wipe it.
Yeah.
Why? Why you want the water? Because you have already removed all the dust. It's a more work you can do, but it is of no use. And why no chain cleaner is required? It's little cheaper also. Why you want to spend 500 rupees for a chain cleaner? You can go 50 rupees or 60 rupees 1 liter diesel. And you can reuse it.
This is a used engine oil we can reuse.
No, you can't use the used engine.
The fresh engine oil?
Fresh engine oil. Or gear, if you are not
gear oil.
If you feel your engine oils are too costly, go with the gear oil. Gear oil, you'll get it for per liter, say 50, 60 rupees. You can mix that oil also.
Mixing the oil is just to avoid the harming of that you are worried. Because only diesel, it may make the ring to be harder. Then after some time, the O-ring gets cracked.
The bolt, you were saying the bolts are different size.
Yeah, by minute, you can't visible.
Because I have opened, but I have mixed them.
Just retight it properly. With the microns, the changes with the micron.
Oh, that much.
Like the same thing he's doing here, he's just cleaning off the excess diesel.
Can we use the WD-40 to clean?
You can use, no issue, that's what I said. You can use the cleaners. It is far cheaper way, that is far costly way. Okay. WD-40 you will get it by 350 or 400 no, per bottle.
Okay.
WD-40 you can use it for switches,
yeah,
in spite of using for chain. After washing, no, just spray to the switches, all the switches and locks.
So what happens that is that, see, water,
good for the bikes.
Water also goes there and sometimes rusting also forms. Okay, that's to avoid rusting to form, that's why you're after some time the switches don't work and all, no?
And I want to convey something. So many people would have faced that petrol tank key is hard to open.
Yeah.
That is quite common in all BS4 because of that evap system. Because your fumes are stored in the tank. So if you are feeling that, just apply Vaseline to the locks. It will free by 1 hour or 2 hours. It will be totally smooth. You can use the WD-40 also. But in spite of WD-40, Vaseline is works better.
More effective.
More effective. We have seen it. That's why.
Mm-hmm.
He is adjusting the chain play. Actually.
How do you do that?
So chain play should be without the load. With free load, it should be 20 to 25 mm. With the load, it should be 10 to 15 mm. With the load, in the sense, person sitting on a bike means 10 to 15 mm play should be there. Not that if you sit on the bike, the slackness should be zero. Many people, many outside garages will do the same thing. With the load, it will be zero slackness. That will elongate a chain, or it may cut your chain, or chain may jump for few times. Few people say that chain sound, tuck tuck sound is coming. That is because your chain is overtight. So with the load, it should be 10 to 15 mm free play. Without the load, 20 to 25 mm.
Without load basically is in the like paddock stand
paddocks.
Or bike, if there is only bike weight, then
bike weight or paddocks. Paddocks also will have bike weight actually. Paddocks
but
are where you are putting. You are putting on the swing arm.
Hmm.
So swing arm is connected to your chassis.
Achha.
Again the bike load is on the bike only.
No, how do you measure?
With center stand?
Huh? With the center stand also same thing.
Same.
20 without load, only bike load, it should be 20 to 25 mm. And people who don't have a center stand or paddocks, put it in the side stand and you can do. Because you don't need that wheel to be free. Without wheel freeness also, you can do adjust the chain. So measuring is with the small tool, we do measuring. Free play case.
How can we measure ourselves this one?
You can buy this tool. You will get it in the JC Road for just 20-30 rupees. It's a small tool. And the free play case coming, plastic. This is a small gauge. It will have till 35 mm measurements. This is a handy tool. So workshop, we use this and this simultaneously. But for customers, we recommend this. This is easy, quite easy to see and adjust. And portable also, you can
what
take
are the
it anywhere.
Name stem for this?
Huh?
What are the name?
Free play gauge.
Free play gauge.
That's it.
You can use a simple scale also, right?
You can.
Same
you can.
Measure balance.
But scale will be length more, no? Because you need to measure 20 to 25 mm. You in you
small
can
scale
use,
we can use.
You
right?
can use 15 centimeter scale, you can use. You have to keep it and do. But this is just small thing.
Mm.
Finger?
And take it in a pocket also.
Finger measurement.
Finger also you can do.
Finger you can do.
No? You can do.
You can do, but the thing is that you'll have to remember Achaita. And this is like a keychain and it can come with your bike keys.
Let everyone see that.
See it and give it back, okay? And we cannot continue the session.
And this tool is with your toolkit.
That is very difficult to open with
that
stock.
Take one.
Then you can buy this.
Yeah, very good.
Okay.
And spanner thing is already available in your toolkit.
Now what do you mean? How do you measure?
First they have to loosen the wheel axle.
Okay. Everyone
loosen
can
the wheel axle, not fully. Don't fully loosen
everyone
and take it off the nut.
Start outside. Spreading because he will be doing. You can come up forward.
Just
move there. You can see from there.
So why we lose the chain is to have access to move. Axle will move only when it is little.
So he reduces the he decreases the
pressure on the axle. That's it.
On the axle is by thumb this. So basically, what he does is that he'll loosen the axle by losing this bolt and holding it from here, and then basic how to loosen you guys know, right? So just loosen it, not completely, keep on two or three threads on and it's loose. Okay, after that you start measuring the thing with the tool.
Okay, before adjusting it, check how much the feet play is. So that you will get an idea to adjust how much
it should be.
20 to 25 mm without load. So it can vary up to 20 mm.
How does he do it?
Just simple, man. So this is your center axis of the chain always. This riveted point. So from that point you keep it in on anything. Keep it on 5 mm or 35 mm. Just move upwards. Where your center axis is going falling in 15 mm. 35 mm minus 15 mm, here is actual free play. That's it.
So you basically measure it from the axle.
Just measure with the point, center point, that's it.
Now what do you do?
First, you have to unlock the lock nut. So lock nut will be against the swing arm. So it stops the rotation of this axle. So we have to unlock this with the 12 spanner.
Both the sides.
Both chain adjustment should be done on the both the sides. Remember this. Many people does on the left side of the part and they leave it. So your chain will be cross aligned. So don't ever do that. If we have provided the marking also in this. If it is 2 here, make sure there also 2, not 1.5 or 1. It should be 2 there also. If you are keeping 2 there and 2 here, chain is little tight, loosen both the sides. Don't loosen one side, and if it is C, one side. If you loosen one side, no, it will get loose little. But your wheel axle will be crossed, little
so
cross.
The other side of the chain will be tight, right?
Other side of the chain will tight, and that will cause uneven wearing of the chain and uneven wearing of your tire also. Your tire also gets uneven wear if you are keeping cross measurements.
And guys, if in between if you missed out or if you want to know it again, stop and ask, okay? Because then we have to start the whole procedure. That's why you ask in the between if you don't understand. Right.
So this is where your adjusting nut is. This is just a lock nut. You have to loosen this. This is the adjusting nut where when you push inside, it will loosen your slackness. When you push out, it will tighten your slackness. So according to the first slackness, how much you got, with that reading, you have to decide whether you have to push the wheel inside further or push outside. So based on that, you just adjust this nut. So there is a marking on the wheel axle also. So against that marking, you have to check with the singaram marking.
So both side is the same. You have to check it and level it accordingly.
Yeah, little force, not that much, because we don't have any spring tension force to get it retracted automatically. And in service center, mostly we always keep the free play for dual ride with the pillion ride also. So if you are specific, you are always a single ride person, just tell them for single rider, adjust the chain so that little slackness will be reduced. So service center basically does for with the pillion ride.
So that and all that, the minute details, anyway you guys come up to see your bike and then you go back home, no? So when you are here, just tell the one of the floor in charges. They will make sure again.
He is loosening the chain, that's why he is pushing. So to push out, you don't require any force, just you loosen this bolt, that bolt force only will push it out the wheel.
The hampering of the wheel is just to get it aligned. See, now he has loosened, he will just press it. In normal vehicle, what we will do, we will rotate the tire wheel and apply the brake so that it gets centralized. That it is pushing. So if anything is there, it completely it gets loose. Then we tight it, it gets centralized.
So in drum brake and all, just before tightening the wheel axle, we used to rotate the wheel, press the brake so that your wheel axle, wheel and everything comes aligned in the straight line. But this is a calipo version. We can't do that. That is why he always beats.
And after doing all this, make sure your wheel axle bolt is tight. Okay, because that is the main thing. If that gets loose slowly, then the wheel will go somewhere, you will go somewhere. So now after doing that, you re-tightening the whole thing again.
Tight the wheel axle, but don't over-tight the wheel axle, thinking safety.
Because it's a lock type tight only. If you see the nut from outside, back side, front side, it is a sealed kind of thing. It will not come out.
So if you over-tight, what happens, no? There may be a pressure on the bolt head which may develop a crack when you are going in a long ride. If you impact on some ditches and all, this heavy tension, no, it is already in overload, may have impact load on it. So don't over tighten it.
What is doing?
What do you remember?
Recheck.
Vehicle also. After tightening the wheel, we supposed to put one snap chain.
So,
but these are self. These are self lock nut only.
What is the right amount of torque then, like
to tighten
it?
Torque will be for wheel axle is 8 kg, 8 to 10 kg normally.
No.
But if you have torque range, many don't have, no. Will not be having.
Nobody has like just a feeling only.
Feel only. So 8 to 10 kg, if you pull, how much pressure you need? That's it.
What is it?
Rechecking the play.
Always. Right, okay.
So this is what he is doing, is he is checking the play in 3 or 4 places.
Oh, everyone.
Confirm that chain is okay. Why, you know, when you adjust properly the chain and if you confirm again, if one or the other place, if the slackness is little loose or little tight, that is the indication that your chain links is getting twisted.
Okay.
So after some period it will get twisted. So that is the indication it is started to twist.
Excited or link tight and as taraf. Will not twist with the tape.
So this guy's chain sprocket is not changed till now.
No,
This is a test drive bike, I think. 20s? Nah, some boss.
11.
Khivraj bike.
11.
11, huh?
Yeah, 11. That means about to be 12.
12,000 kilometers. So normal O-ring chain is life is 15, man.
15, 16.
20 is who maintains it fully is 20. 15 is the max many people get.
And Samuel, we have seen people telling that the O-ring for 30,
35,000
kilometers, even without taking
the
chain.
That is true. That is where their chain would have been, that link would have been twisted. Example, Rafiq case only. His chain link was twisted in 18,000 kilometer only.
Okay.
But he go with that till 30,000. But the only thing is, negative side is, you will get the chain noise. Chain jumping noise will be there. You can keep the chain little loose and you can use it. But the thing is, you will get the noise. If you are okay with the noise, you can ride till the full slackness gets away. So after 30,000, we have to replace because his chain got slipped from the bike in the run of Kutch ride. Two times it got slipped. That is the extreme condition.
After 500 kilometers, it's going to have some chain slack, right?
Yes.
So what exactly is happening? Is the wheel axle moving forward or is my chain link?
Chain getting expanded, that's it.
Oh, is it? Nothing about
nothing
with the wheel.
So before this, when he tightened it, when he was checking it, it turned out to be little too tight. So what he did was he had to
readjust
the whole thing again.
That you have to do. No thing of laziness at all. Okay, let it be little tight. I'll adjust. No. Make sure if it is little loose also, it will not cause you anything. But if it is tight,
rubber.
No. It is a serious
okay, everyone, concern. If you can just come and just, you know, see this. This should be
this
when after tightening,
play.
It should feel like this.
You can feel it.
Visual play.
Okay.
So always just keep your finger on the swing arm and just try feeling it. So when you're checking it, right, always like measure this part.
No, side stand end.
Side stand end, okay, fine. That's better. Side stand end and always keep it on the link, okay? And check it like this. That's how you know your chain is fine.
And whenever you're adjusting the chain, just have a look on the chain pad also.
Ye do log ke liye
chain pad is open or not. Because your chain pad is your lifesaver.
What is chain pad?
This is the chain pad.
Normal.
The below part and upper part,
you have
that is the pad.
The push thing.
Yes, yes. It should not be cut. Just have a look. Because that saves more in the ride.
So when we...
If it is cut, no. While driving, if it gets suddenly open, it can jam your chain. It can jam your chain and stall your engine.
So when you change the sprocket, the whole thing, so you're going to change that?
No, we are not going to change it. If it is damaged or something only, we are going to change it.
Actually, it is lifetime only.
Hey, how do you get to know sprocket?
It is remember.
Sprocket is gone. By seeing something, you need to know.
Chain play will be uneven.
No, but looking at this only.
Since working, you can't.
Sprocket.
Huh?
Damper or slider?
A slider is provided actually. So old bikes we called back for slider fitment, who had 18 version, they would have remembered. The whole point was to, if a slider gets damaged also, to hold it in the position. Not to move out of its position, we fix that slider actually. But, yeah, it is default. And whenever you adjust the chain, just have a look of this play. See, this play should not be there. If this play is there, just replace your coupling rubbers. This play should not be there.
Coupling rubbers come inside here.
So this needs to be replaced. This one
chain sprocket only is not replaced.
With the chain sprocket, you change that assembly.
That also. If without changing also, we can change it. If it is play is more. because that is a main point where you are getting a
low torque
drag, everything comes there only actually.
How much play like should be?
Play should be zero.
Zero play only.
Zero play only. It should be tight intact.
Lubing.
And lubing the chain. Always do at the corners, both the corners, not on the center of the chain. Whatever you do in the center of the chain is waste. Nothing going to loop your chain.
So there is a lot of debate on the spray and the oil. So which you recommend? Oil or the spray?
I said no. Any brand other than
motor. No. I mean there is like you get aftermarket filters also. It's like you have seen the thousands.
No, aftermarket filters I don't recommend because I checked it. It doesn't have your dust filter. And right. Your throttle body, if dust enters into your throttle body, it will cost you around 6 to 7k.
So what he's done right now while you were talking is that he was lubing this portion, the corners, and he was lubing this portion as well.
Near the bearing.
So that more free space, free play is there.
You can go for stock air filters only because you are going to change it for every 15,000 kilometers. And it will cost you around 250 to 300 rupees, that's it. Your aftermarket BMC is around 2k or 3k, no?
4.5.
Why you want to spend 4.5k
no,
or you can go just spend 250 rupees.
Also
now, what I'm telling is you have this back can, what is that, your filter, right? I mean the oil can in the race side, there's a suspension.
Yeah.
So you get a can near the
front
handle.
Also.
Yeah. So the same, there's a wire which comes, I think, 30 ml, I think the brake fluid itself.
Okay.
It comes near the chain and you have a brush also, which you have with the cleaning brush.
Okay.
So it does clean once you press and there's a button. Once you keep on pressing it, the oil comes and lubricates the chain. So you can do it with the standing position
it's
on the
product.
Double stand.
It's a product. Two, it's okay. If four is go, it's not going, it is between 2 and 4. Means 3. It's okay. If it is, I'll make it loose and I'll show you how to. When you loose, put it there. And the 12, 14. This spanner also, you have 12 and 14 is used for clutch play adjustment.
Senthil, if we move the handle, no, the clutch play changes.
Changes.
Right? So
always keep it in the straight position.
So straight we have to adjust.
If you adjust in the straight, that is enough. So while driving, no, only when you are in the slow speed we'll rotate the handle.
Yeah, correct.
In high speeds you will not rotate the handle, you will build the bike.
Correct.
Loose panel first. Our trip if you loose or not, more of the case loose only you will adjust. No? Tight is rare.
Yeah.
And if it is loose, little loose also you can ride, but if it is tight, don't ride. It will definitely wear your face plates.
So you have to loosen the outer and then
same pattern, like chain only. One nut is used to lock the other nut is used to adjust it. That's it. Same thing. See, now it is loose. Now the 4 also goes, 6 also goes. So bring it to normal play. See how there is tightening. The 12 size nut will be used for adjusting and 14 size nut will be used to lock the 12 size nut.
14 size adjusting.
Pita kodutirpiya.
Mutala, that's correct. 12 take.
So for tightening, you have to move clockwise, right?
Same. Not same theory. Loosening anti-clockwise, tightening clockwise. And don't apply excess grease on the clutch cable. Actually, clutch cables don't require any lubricant.
But when they change
the
outer
or put something. Maintenance free clutch cables actually. They were there, the old age,
used to put the oil in.
That is not recommended for this type of clutch cable because it's already free maintenance. If it is hard, don't lubricate, replace it. Because mostly you'll replace after 20,000 only.
Correct.
Till that you can use it. So
this one, this can you explain how to, like what is the...
Simple, function? This is you have to use with the cutting player. Just, if you can't use that, you don't have spanners, no? Just loosen this. And according to the play, you just loosen and keep on loosening it.
Mm.
Your play will be tight. Then, this is used for locking the play.
Mm.
That's it.
So either any one of them?
Either anyone.
Anyone.
Don't do both. So this is emergency purpose.
So when it is in half clutch, I mean, when you know the cable is going to cut, you have to use it with very loose.
Very loose.
Yeah.
And brake fluid, start setting. Yeah? Brake fluid, no? Checking the brake fluid for rear is very easy.
Yeah.
But front, many people get confused, no? Just put a torch on it. You will get a golden reflection on this. If you are getting a golden reflection, brake fluid is there. If you are not getting a golden reflection, if you can see only metals, brake fluid is not there. That's the only thing you can do with the brake fluid. Golden reflection will
golden.
Be.
Golden reflection.
Because brake fluid is gold pale color. Pale yellow it is.
Like green. The one that is visible there on the can, this one, no?
Can.
Can, yeah.
That is, because here we have only little opening, no? That is
so it looks so transparent there.
We can't provide this as a transparent thing because pressure is more here.
Okay.
So to safety, we have provided metal
one.
Rear one, same thing I said, no?
Mm.
70% brake pressure is for front only. 30 is bad. So you can use their plastic. But here I can't use the plastic.
So we always have this question, like why the rear brake is always on the, you know, like the pressure is on the lower side. Because it isn't that effective. Like if you are coming from a other segment of bikes wherein we have been used for using the rear brakes quite often than using the front brakes.
See, this chassis design is of perimeter type, we say.
Okay.
So here we are hanging the engine on the chassis. We are not placing the engine.
Okay.
We are hanging with the only three bolts. So
Achha,
the
okay.
axle load of the engine
it's
is on front
on
axle only, not the back axle. So what happens if I give the same pressure, brake pressure to the back, no? Fishtail happenings. Your bike may have experienced the fishtail. You may feel the control, uncontrolled stability of the bike.
Okay.
That is why.
So only to avoid the skid, see, hope you remember the old vehicle also, the drum type. If you make it hard, na, it gets skid.
No, if you want,
now it
you
is
can
a
drive
disc
brake.
With more,
just remove the ABS.
Usually, we have a tendency to apply
the brake with
the
back brake.
Then it
easily
may
your
bike
skid
it gets scared.
That's the reason to avoid.
But with
much
the same
locking
condition,
ones.
Use the skidding brake. Your bike will not skid.
It is
without ABS
on the
ground.
Okay.
Proper braking technique. That's it. Nothing other.
And
okay.
You take any super bike also, even the rear part will be on lesser side. Because more power lies on your rear, you will need more brake. If you give more efficiency brake, then obviously it's going to be skid.
And one of your people had that in emergency, if self-start is not working, to take it to nearest dealer, what I have to do? Just simple thing, first check the fuses. First main fuse is your kill switch fuse, that is 15 amps fuse. If your lightings all are working, directly check the kill switch fuse, that is 15 amps. The fuse specifications are written on this. So just according to that specification, check the fuses. So check, visually you can check the fuse, no? Just I'll remove and show all fuses.
Link has cut to the fuse as well.
That's it.
Center.
You have to check the link. If the link is open, then
inside.
Yeah.
So in long ride you prefer to take one or two fuses?
Three spare fuses will be provided with the bike.
One
if
each.
You want you can take it.
7.5 to 30.
See that is, you don't need to remember. The sticker is there. Just according to the sticker you go with it. Even with the fuse also okay, then also your kill switch is failed.
Yeah.
This is your relay. We say starter relay. Just direct that relay, vehicle will start.
Super.
You can take it to nearest dealer without off switching off the engine.
How to do that?
Just have the two insulations. Just within the two insulation, put any metal part which conducts.
Okay.
It will start your bike. That's it. And you should not.
We need to have something like metal.
You can use that
screwdriver.
You need to short it, right? Just short those
just
both terms.
Can you just short once now?
Yeah, like, can we see
that
actually?
Practical.
He should be on position.
Okay.
That's the main thing. And use this is only for emergency.
Yeah.
Because it's quite dangerous also.
The thing is,
it may damage the ECU.
Latch it today. Clean it. And sit for this one.
அது பண்ணிட்டு வேணாம் அவங்களுக்கு எமர்ஜென்சிக்கு
எமர்ஜென்சிக்கு அப்படியே போட சொல்லு இப்போ க்ளீனாக காமிச்சிடல அப்போ எமர்ஜென்சியில் மெயின் டவுட் ஆகுனா சர்ச்சி
எங்கே வச்சிருக்கேன்
ராச்சட் பாக்ஸ் மேலே
இருக்கு மேலே மேலே பண்ணுறேன் டூ ஃபார் யோர் விசிபிலிட்டி இஸ் செலிங் இஸ் ஓப்பன் திஸ் கவர் டு ஷோ யூ ப்ராப்பர்லி
Sandil, which is the relay?
This is the relay. This is the big part.
Part so
big.
Okay.
6K. Just 5 minutes or so.
Sandil, what's the cost of all these green colored bottles?
6 to 7? With the stickers.
Just for the transparent 3M.
Is that now jumper cable use smart
GPU?
Jumper cable? ATM board.
Smart board. Jump start smart.
So in case
if... the battery no chana giddi and gaadi start aagilla na dealer thond hogidiga
lug tag nodabodalla starting
break aagidhe lug galalla fault barak chance illa it's a twin HD coil.
So if battery is worn out, then we have to push start, no? That's the
if
only way.
If battery is low, you can't push start also. Because this bike starts with the battery only. So without battery, you can't. If battery is low, if you push, if you direct this, vehicle will not start. You have to have a battery voltage above 11 volts is minimum. Above 11 is minimum. If it is below 11, it won't start only. Because all your sensors are connected to the battery. Even the engine horn also, if you disconnect the positive terminal of the battery, vehicle gets off.
Okay, but if engine starts running, there is a dynamo, right? Inside, like...
That is the problem, that the old bikes will have the AC supply directly connected to your
circuits,
vehicle power supply. In this bike, this is a DC ignition, we say.
Okay.
So whatever your dynamo is used to, only to charge the battery. Nothing else
it does. Okay.
From battery only everything works because ECU is a very sensitive device. Small voltage fluctuation will damage it. So it needs a steady current. Only from battery you will get steady current.
So if you push it for long enough, can the dynamo charge it and then start?
So dynamo for charging the battery you need 2000 RPM.
Okay.
If you can push to 2000 RPM, then you can charge it.
Okay, so you understand.
Just touch the two bolts.
ಓಪನ್
ಮಾಡಿ ಡಿ ಐ ವೈ ವಿಲ್ put some more emergency steps we can do.
Mm-hmm.
We'll add it to this. We can do many methods are there. If fuel pump fails also, we can start
the bike.
There are methods to start
frame
everything.
Delay,
for everything, there is a method.
Pump relay.
That is used only for emergency and that can be used only till 20-30 kilometers. After that, again the engine comes to normal position only.
You
can't bypass and use it for lifetime.
Bandesh.
This also, you start with this also, for 20-30
kilometers,
it
can stop for you.
This is only for emergency purpose.
Light for it.
How much is the battery life?
They give 1 year warranty.
It's now it is revised, no?
4 years. Huh?
Not 4 years. Say 18 months warranty. For all 5 years bike, we'll have 18 months of battery warranty. 2019.
No, sir, it's been
how much it lasts?
How much it lasts? Just apply
stamps
petroleum jelly which avoids sulfation. That's it.
So basically, friends, that's all we had for this session. However, Khivraj Bajaj has promised us to give us more such interesting contents in the future. So thank you everyone for watching the video till the end. I believe this video has helped you all. If it did, please don't forget to hit the like button and stay subscribed to my YouTube channel because I'm gonna post more such interesting contents in the future. So, see you all in my next video. Until then, love you all. Take care. See ya.